The global linkages between China, Europe, and the New World do not end there. Another vitally important linkage was that of silver. Following the voyages of Columbus and the violent and rapid expansion of Spanish Empire in the Americas, one of the principal effects this had for European society was the rapid influx of silver, mined by effectively slave labor in the New World mines of Potosí and elsewhere. While the initial effect of this influx of silver was to help lubricate trade and finance, this unprecedented influx of silver ultimately decreased the value of this metal, setting up a period of widespread inflation known as the Price Revolution. This inflation cycle was so severe that it called into question the very economic viability of Spanish Empire in the Americas, insofar as New World colonialism was dependent heavily upon the value of Spanish silver extraction. In a strange irony, what saved the global silver trade, and therefore Spanish conquest of the Americas, was in many ways the strength of the Chinese economy at this time. Silver had become, first de facto and then officially, part of the empire's currency system. While everyday purchases were done in what was known as copper currency, larger purchases, such as the payment of taxation, or for the purposes of long-distance finance, was conducted in silver. For this reason, China became one of the principal consumers of New World silver. During the late Ming and Qing dynasties, that is, from the 1500s onward, immense quantities of New World silver were imported to China by way of Spanish-controlled Manila and other avenues. This silver lubricated the Chinese economy, resulting in greater regional specialization within the empire, as well as large-scale inter-regional trade in non-luxury goods. It also helped fuel the growth of empire-wide banking networks and the emergence of some of the most phenomenally wealthy merchant dynasties in China, the richest families that China, and indeed the world, had ever known.